Hello. Mr. True with you here again today. You've been hearing me talk a lot in my stats class about, or my videos, about data and this idea of normal data. And all you've heard me say up until this point is that normal data follows a bell-shaped distribution. Well, today we're actually going to verify that normality. So, what we're going to do that, now of course the other day I did define normal data as data that follows the empirical rule. And the empirical rule is, if you move left or right, or both, left and right, one standard deviation from the mean, you will hold 68% of the data. If you move left and right two standard deviations from the mean, you'll be holding 95% of the data. And if you move left or right three standard deviations, that will be holding 99.7% of the data. So, the empirical rule is 68, 95, 99.7. And if your data follows that pattern, then your data is indeed normal, but that is very hard to check manually. So what we have instead is something called the normal probability plot. It will graph the univariate data that you have on one axis and the standardized test statistic on the other axis. And at this point, our textbook is using just z-scores for that standard test statistic. So let's see what that looks like. I'm going to turn my calculator, well, it's already on, so I'm going to go to Stat, Edit, and you see that I have quite a few values typed into list 1. Okay, we're going to see now that that data is right skewed by making a histogram. So second, stat plot, I'm going to turn the first one on, actually it already is on, I'm going to choose histogram, which it's already selected, and my data is in list 1, zoom 9, okay, clear it again, zoom 9. And as you can see, my data is indeed very, very right skewed, to the point where you can't even see the height of these classes over here, but it is a double line, so there's a little bit of data over there. Now, on standardized tests, a lot of times they'll ask you to compare a histogram to a box plot and see if you can identify the correct pairing. Well, we're going to be looking for a box plot that is right skewed, and we're also going to be looking for, well, not here, but a tip for you is to also match up where the median is. That's the center line of a box plot. Sometimes you need to identify that median from the histogram and match it with the box plot graphs to get a proper pairing. And for practice, you may want to, when you make a histogram, turn two plots on. One for the histogram, and turn another plot on as a box plot and overlay the two. So I'm going to turn plot two on, turn it on. I'm going to select a regular box plot, even though normally I prefer modified box plots, because identifying outliers is not going to be very appropriate since this data is clearly not normal. And that means a lot more pieces of data will fail that IQR test than they should, so we're just going to go ahead and do the regular box plot. Hit zoom 9. And there we have the histogram and the right skewed box plot laid on top of it. Now, every time that we have one really long whisker in one direction, that does not automatically mean skewness. It could also mean an outlier. So why does this box plot show that it's skewed to the right? Well, you can't see it in this picture very well, but if your intervals increase as you go to the right, then it is right skewed. Whereas if your first three quarters are all basically evenly spaced and you have one long whisker, that's probably an outlier and not indeed skewness. So we have a right skewed histogram and a right skewed box plot laid on top of it, and you can see the median is somewhere within that first interval of 41 to 117. That's quite a spread for that first grouping, that first class width. Let's see how the skewness shows up in a normal probability plot. Well, and what is a normal probability plot? We're going to plot the, again, original data on one axis and the standardized test scores on the other axis. In this case, it'll be z-scores. If we see an approximately linear pattern, that is going to be normality. If we have z-scores on the x-axis, I'm going to match the way my textbook does it. With my z-scores on the x-axis, if the largest observations fall distinctly above the line drawn through the main body of points, this will be something that you visualize. It's not going to be on my graph here in a minute. Then the distribution is going to be right skewed. That means your positive z-scores are more spread out, and that's what a right skewed distribution does. Your mean might be somewhere over here, and all these values with positive z-scores are going to be obviously much more spread out than the negative z-scores. If the smallest numbers fall below the line that you can visualize through the main body of points, then the distribution is left skewed. Let's see how that looks. Second stat plot, I'm going to turn them all off in one step because I want to make a completely different type of graph. Second stat plot again, choose one, and turn it back on since I just turned it off. And again, this is a scatter plot with the dots connected, histogram, modified box plot that does the IQR test for us automatically, regular box plot, and now the normal probability plot. Hit enter. And you'll see that it asks where the data is. We only have one list of data. This is for univariate quantitative data we're talking about here with this test. And where would you like the data? You can put the data on the x-axis, which means the z-scores will be on the y, or put your data on the y-axis and have your z-scores be on the x-axis. I'm going to match my my textbook that my students are using, so I'm putting my data on the y-axis, but it really makes no difference. I'm going to hit zoom 9, and let's see. Here's our data, and this is a little bit of line showing up for some other problem I was going to do in a later video, so let me turn that off. If you hit enter on the equal sign, you can leave an equation in your calculator but not visually see the graph, so sorry about that. Here's our normal probability plot again. Now, it is, as we said a minute ago, right skewed. And if I take this piece of paper that I'm using to cover up some of my wood flooring and just sort of use the edge of it as a straight line through the main body of points where those points are all very tightly packed together, do you see how a lot of points fall above the line? That's what I'm speaking of here where I say that's a sign of right skewness, and we saw a minute ago that our histogram was right skewed. If you saw the opposite pattern again, if you could visualize a straight line through these points and see that a lot of points fell below the line, which is, you know, this is not that case, but that would be left skewed. So there we have it, a normal probability plot. We'll put the z-scores or standard test statistics along one axis, in this case it's the x, the data along the y-axis, and if you see a linear pattern, it's approximately linear, and if you don't, that's a sign of skewness. And just as one more step, if I hit window, look at that x-axis. The min is negative 3 and the max is negative 3. Now, it doesn't have to be that tight of an interval, but remember we talked about the empirical rule, where it's 68% of your data is withheld within one standard deviation, 95% of your data is held within two standard deviations, and 99.7% of the data is held within three. Well, then it makes sense that our x-axis is between positive and negative three z-scores, or positive, negative three standard deviations, because again, with z-scores, the unit of measure for z-score is the number of standard deviations. And my y, max, and min, now I had no negative numbers typed in there, so I could, you know, reset that to zero if for some reason I wanted to do that, and hit graph again, but my y values went up quite a bit, which is why my y min and y max are so widely spread out. Let's see. And here we see the x-axis right against the bottom of the window. So one more time, no more probability plots will, in one very easy graph, help you verify if data is truly normal. Thank you very much. Have a great, great day.